Hello everyone, welcome to a factional fight plays Wurm Online. My name is Ryan, that's my brother Adam over there. And today we're going to be doing a little bit different. We are going to, of course, talk about all the hot topics on the forums. We're going to talk to all of you guys in the chat. And we are going to, of course, continue the labyrinth. Right, Adam?
Yep, and we're gonna try to fix all the mess ups that you made.
Yeah. So last week I announced that I made a bunch of mistakes. And that is, we're gonna try to fix some of them, and we actually found more mistakes. Did I make them or did Adam make them? I don't know. Find out after the break. Let's do this. Okay, I made the mistake. I'm sorry. I didn't realize I was making any mistakes. This is probably how mistakes are made. I'm fairly certain I counted how many tiles were from the entrance of the labyrinth to this, what would you call it, this archway.
Yeah.
Apparently I was wrong. Adam found this out the other day. So what exactly were you doing?
I was essentially trying to complete the work that we started on the last episode, and that is open up all the mine entrances. And I was working my way back towards the end of the, you know, the back of the labyrinth, and I was just counting out tiles, and I realized there was an extra tile along the way, and I must have counted it like 10 times to make sure I was like seeing this right. And it was, yeah, the issue was that the plans was exactly one tile shorter than the actual space that we have in the labyrinth. So that messed everything up. And the the options were either redo the plans or to just fix the labyrinth.
And I chose redo the plans.
Yeah.
And Adam chose let's fix it all. So of course we're fixing it all.
You know,
and what was your reasoning behind that choice?
So as it is, we used up about half the space that we have for the front area of the labyrinth. And you know, That part is going to be like the Pac-Man labyrinth area. And then the back half is going to be a whole city and a village and a castle and everything like that. And that, in my opinion, is the more exciting part of it all. And we reserved a little bit extra space for that side, maybe a few extra tiles. And by, you know, shaving off a tile, it is actually taking away a lot of space that we would, you know, a lot of real estate that we need there. So I don't know. I don't think it's that much work. It just means that we have to rebuild that archway one tile forward and move the entire dirt wall one tile forward. And I think we got the dirt for it, considering.
It's not that hard. Just move the entire wall one tile forward.
Yeah.
So before anyone realizes, I am not in front of my own computer. I am on a laptop. I don't have my microphone. It might sound a little fuzzy, so sorry about that. I'm in a different room. I do have this picture. I see you guys talking about it in the chat. There is a picture behind me. I haven't looked at it yet. Yes, it is a picture of Wurm. I see some trees. I see some, you know, grass. It's gotta be Wurm. Got some water. What else does Wurm have? Guy? I don't know. Rocks. So what are we doing? So what exactly is the problem. We are going to move. We're going to move this archway one tile forward.
Mm-hmm.
And the problem is that it's not as easy as it sounds.
No.
And it, quite a while, and maybe you can explain, Adam, why it's not.
I started working on it, and I got about halfway through. It's not that it's hard, it's that it just takes time. The idea is that, so the way I did it is I essentially started in the top middle. See, this tile here was the old top of the archway, and it went down like that, and so I just leveled out one tile out this way, and I started doing the same strategy we did before, which we never really showed on the
video. Didn't even talk about it.
Yeah, I don't think we even talked about our strategy, so I guess we can show it here. The one thing I found really sucky was that because one tile is almost already flat, like one border here is already flat, if I level this tile, it takes forever again. You're really only raising one point. And what I found is that what we could do is if we level this tile here and then level this tile and then just bring this tile up here, it goes a lot faster because you can do 2 points at once. So why don't we get started on that?
Okay. Yeah. Move that part over here, and then we can show what you mean by leveling stuff.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I think that should be good enough. Spark. Okay, so now the way that you have to do this sort of stuff is because you need to be on a level tile already in order to level things. I think that it's best if we start like where I'm standing here.
Okay.
You know, grab a bunch of dirt and level this one first.
Go ahead.
The one that the what do you call it is on. Let me see if I have my keybinds for it. Yeah, I got it.
You do not have any keybinds, but that's okay.
Yeah.
Just hope I'm doing what.
Yeah, unfortunately your internet is a little bit crappy, so every so often you garble out, but
yeah. Sorry about that. The internet is kind of bad here. It's okay.
Yeah.
It'll only be for this week. Just for this episode.
Deal with what we do. Okay, so I got that one flat. And now we want to get the next one flat.
We want to get the next one flat. We can do that.
So level it up.
Leveling. Okay, so yeah, it's not hard, it just takes time. Pretty much sums up Wurm in general. Isn't that a true comment, Adam?
Yeah, and we discussed that last week. Somebody made that comment on the video. And I think that, you know, I was thinking about it afterwards, and I was thinking, you know, some things do take a little bit of thinking. Like, for example, the old school flat raising stuff.
Yeah.
Right? Like, not everybody was able to do that.
And by everybody, you mean you.
I mean, I suppose. I figured it out. I found it really frustrating. And I started to, because, you know, leveling doesn't fix every single problem. And sometimes flat raising, or just flattening, using the flattening command is actually useful in some situations. I started to figure it out, so I feel confident that if the level command disappeared, that I'd be able to flat raise just fine.
Right.
But yeah. It's still like pretty complicated, I'd say. Something that even, you know, I had difficulty with. And I could imagine others having difficulty with it as well.
And so you guys can see sort of what we're doing. We're bringing up the tile to level it. And then the actual slope that we want to raise, we're raising sort of two what would you call it, 2 points at a time. And then after we raise it all the way up to the top here, that's when we lower it. Does that make any sense? Did I just...
Yeah.
I have no idea.
I mean...
A little bit... I'm drinking a little bit.
We'll have to show it exactly. It's the method that I use to build ramps. Maybe it's not the most efficient. I don't know what is.
Something better than what we're doing right now. We're wondering why we're doing it this way. Tell us a better way of doing it, and we will. We'll gladly.
Yeah, I know. Seriously, if you can tell us how to improve our method here, because I find this method pretty lengthy and pretty inefficient, but for getting slopes, like the slope on the side of this thing, once we level this all up, is going to be like 100 or something, or 150. And then I want to create a ramp, you know, going down where there doesn't exist a ramp. Like, it would be like if you're standing on the top of a mountain and you just want a ramp that goes straight out from that mountain. Okay, so the way that I do it is I level a tile in front of me, I level the next tile out in front of me, and then that farthest out tile I dig down so that it's 20 slope below but also flat. I don't know. We'll show exactly how.
All right. While we're doing this, a bunch of topics that have come up, some that have interested me a bunch. I don't remember exactly. Like, you remember one.
Well, you know what? I think I'm gonna start with the news updates. I think that's a good place to start.
All right. So what happened this week in the news of Wurm?
I think the biggest one is that the elevation map was released.
The elevation map was released finally. So yeah. Like, you're talking about,
like, the elevation server
that they
opened.
Maps.
Sorry?
Did the elevation server open?
Yeah, that's what I mean to say. That the elevation server opened, everybody joined it, and it's been pretty quiet, I think. And I think that's because everybody's just busy working away on it.
Okay. Yeah. That. What do you think? You said last week that they released a crappy map that no one liked. And then they came back and they released a better one?
Yeah. So the first map was like all water, tiny islands. Everybody hated it. So, you know, I was very surprised at the response that Rolf himself came up onto the forums and said, you know, so okay, you guys hate this map. I'm gonna make a new one. And then he released it, let everybody have a look at it. Everybody said that they loved it, and he, you know,
yeah,
went with it. I think that just the fact that he listened to the feedback and decided to switch it before, you know, this is just a smart move. Something that you don't necessarily see very often. Like, for example, when Xanadu was released, nobody even saw the map before it was released.
Okay. So let's bring this into the context of, you know, all of us PvE players. Mm-hmm. What is one thing, I don't know, you guys in the chat, or you, Adam, or you guys on YouTube, that you hate about PvE?
One thing that we hate about PvP? Or PvE?
Yeah.
One thing that I hate about PvE. Well, let's first get back to this ramp, because that's where we're at. And we're going to bring this down by 5.
Do this ramp. We're bringing it down by 5. Why?
Okay, so to get that arch, and we can match this side. To get the arch, we're going to start with a very shallow slope, 5, and then get, you know, more steep as we move forward. Okay, so we'll just
match.
So
we're copying the one on.
Yeah, copy that side. Okay, and I'm pretty sure I made the ending. Okay, so we're going to basically... Oh, there you go. Yeah. The idea is to make it so that the tile that's next to us that we're digging, that's the tile that's going to be sloped by 5. So I want this slope to be 5. There's the top, the flat top, and then it's going to be sloped down by 5. And then I'll bring this tile flat so that I have another flat tile to stand on to level the next one.
Ah.
And I go forward from there like that.
I see.
Whoa, something might be happening on this screen. Yes.
All right, so let's look
on this screen. And this is not good because I'm stuck someplace that I don't recognize.
And this is Adam talking about how he's playing multiple characters.
Let's see if I can get myself out of this.
Okay, so here's some of the response. Tries to get himself out. Trolls, I hate trolls. Yeah, I think everyone hates trolls. I don't think that's necessarily a PvE thing. The combat system, because it's not similar to a game called Mountain. And half of the finished skill line. Such potential in so many fields. Yeah. There are some skills that I feel like don't have the amount of potential. What could you say of them are alchemy? There's even leatherworking is neglected if you compare it to
Yeah, like in the sense that leatherworking has very little, what's the word? Recipes?
Yeah.
Uh-oh, I see the halo.
What are all the new ones that they added? One in thatching. Sorry, paving actually got a good update. But that...
I'm sorry, guys. This is really careless of me. I'm stuck inside a
yo-yo
pen with these spiders who are kicking my butt. I don't know if I'm going to be able to survive this, and I also don't know where I am.
Uh-oh.
Which is a very interesting situation that I'm not usually in.
That's what happens on work.
Yeah, and this person is very good at locking all their fences to prevent me.
And there's a question. Are you drinking milk from a tiny cart? I am drinking something from a tiny... Or am I just extremely large right now?
Here's a question. If I go into a mine, do mobs still chase me in there, or do they stop? Actually, no, that mine has water in it, so that's not a good idea.
Uh-oh.
I don't know how I could have possibly gotten to where I am, because I was on a cart, and I left it stationary. And then when I alt-tabbed back, I'm not in my cart anymore, but rather in somebody's pen, with all the doors locked, being hit by 4 spiders, a hellhound, and a wolf.
That sounds like some sort of intervention there. Unless you're talking about a different character.
Different character. I don't know where I am. Oh, I see a road. If I get there...
I think Rolf himself said he wanted a more active combat system. And from what I remember, I don't know if you remember, Adam.
Mm-hmm.
He did make a post a long time ago about how he wanted to do a more active combat system, but when someone said mentioned something like Mountain Blade,
yeah,
which is, you know, like a reactive combat system, somebody throws arrows at you, you put up your shield and you block it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but I think
you can't do that basically. you just can't.
I think, what about even, like, a system like Minecraft? Like, it's not a Mountain Blade, obviously, but it's like It's essentially you click the button and you swing your sword, and I don't know, can you block in Minecraft?
I don't know. I haven't played it long enough to know.
Hmm. Yeah, I mean,
but they could never have something exactly like that. I think what he was talking about, I can't remember exactly, something like you can hit a different location. You want to make it more strategic.
I mean, I think you can already do that, can't you?
Yeah, and he wanted to just make it more, like, faster, I guess. I don't know.
Okay.
Who knows?
So are we good here? Remember. Did we get a flat tile? Yeah.
We got a flat tile, so let's raise the next one.
Okay.
We bring this guy closer onto the flat tile.
Closer, yeah, that's good.
And let's raise it up. And while we raise that, and Adam tries to correct his issues that he's having.
I don't even know what I'm going to do, because I do kind of need this character back. The only thing I can do is start like an exploration to figure out where I am.
Yeah, it's gonna take a lot longer than this episode.
So maybe I'll just scrap that idea and...
Why don't you just head in a direction that you know would eventually lead you to water?
I'm at water. So I must have headed in a direction where there's water. So that could have either been north or south that I was walking in. So I'm gonna guess I was going north, and I'm just going to start heading south.
Well, there you go. There was another topic on the forum that really interested us this week. We got into a big debate about it off camera, and eventually it was weird because we never used to do this, but we were talking about it, or I don't remember where we were at the time, but we were about this topic on the forums, and eventually we're just like, well, let's stop the conversation and instead wait until we're doing the video to talk about it.
Yeah, I don't think we've ever done that before.
Oh, how our video series has changed us. Yeah. We stopped our regular conversation to have it now. On the internet.
Yeah.
So what was that about?
The question somebody posed on the forums was, how can we get more people to play Wurm?
There's a lot of people who responded to this, I found.
Mm-hmm. It's become a big thread, I think. And a lot of the response...
Why?
A lot of the response was, you know... Like, you can't really, because Wurm is what it is, and people are going to either like it or not, or, you know. But you know what?
Right, so,
I think that from our perspective, this is a question that we've asked ourselves since the beginning, since we started playing, pretty much. Like, why hasn't everybody figured out this game, or, you know, like, discovered this game, and, you know, I mean... It doesn't seem to make sense that we found this game and then all of a sudden fell in love with it so quickly, and yet so many other people who are out there probably never heard of it, who would probably love the game.
Right.
But I think that we realize that this game isn't quite... What's the word? It won't appeal to everybody. Actually, it won't appeal to a lot of people.
We know that.
Yeah.
We're accepting of that.
Yeah, I think we're accepting of it.
The question is, what do you think? Here's the question.
Yeah, okay.
Would you think that Wurm could benefit from advertisement?
From advertisement? Absolutely. Now, the main...
You feel that... Yeah?
the main argument against advertising Wurm is that you're going to get a ton of people in here who, you know, who will basically give bad reviews of the game because they're not, this isn't the type of game for that person. You know what I mean?
Yeah. You take on the debate, the argument that Wurm is for a very specific kind of player, you might as well not advertise that. Because they don't exist.
It's not that they don't exist, you know?
Like too many players that aren't that type of player, therefore you shouldn't advertise.
Yeah. I mean, the thing is that those players exist. Players who would enjoy Wurm, who would stick with it, and who haven't yet discovered the game. Those people exist. For sure they exist. But the problem is that that type of player is in such a minority.
Yeah, and here's the comment. The game appeals to a very niche market. Most that try it will hate it. Yeah. Let's say that statement is true completely. Most that try it will hate it. Mm-hmm. If you're an advertising person or Wurm, and you believe that, you believe, okay, I'm hired to make Wurm popular. And I know that most people will not like it that play it. Mm-hmm. What do I do?
You have to make sure that the people who try it are the people who will like it. Or at least that some of the people who try it like it. You can't have, you know, like, you have to target the marketing so that the people who see your advertisement are the people who are looking for this type of game. Okay, so my first thought was, how would I go about finding a game like this? Like, let's say I'm looking for a survival sandbox style game. Like, that's what I'm kind of looking for. A crafting builder game or whatever. The first thing that I'm going to do is go to Google and type in sandbox games or whatever. Sandbox MMOs or, I don't know, a whole bunch of stuff.
Yeah.
Just
how did we find the game?
I mean,
how did all of you guys find the game?
Yeah,
yeah,
exactly. How did everybody find the game? We searched for it. We searched for that specific type of game that will, you know, satisfy the criteria that we're looking for. For example, when I was taking a little bit of breaks from Wurm, I'd look for other sandbox games just to see, like, what are the other sandbox games looking like? How do they compare to Wurm? I tried a few, like Zion or whatever it's called, or a bunch of others.
Yeah.
Okay, good. I got my alt back. And the way that I found those is I would look for sandbox MMO lists, you know, top 25 sandbox MMOs, or I would go to other, like, websites devoted to it, like Sandboxer, sandboxer.org. They've done a bunch of articles on Wurm. And then I'd be reading up on all these different types of sandboxy games and what makes games sandbox. And I found that a lot of sandbox games aren't actually, like, open world, open-ended. A lot of them are like Guild Wars, or for some reason they consider Guild Wars sandbox. Or they consider, like, games where it's like it's a theme park game, but you can choose the way you customize your character as sandbox. So I started seeing, like, sandbox meaning a whole bunch of different things that I didn't quite agree with. And then I started having to refine my, like, search. Like, I want to get a sandbox game that has, you know, open-ended crafting and you know, no level caps, and I don't know, a whole bunch of other stuff. I don't think we need to level that.
If I was the guy that was
Brian, I don't think we need to level that.
You don't want to do what you were talking about before, which is leveling.
No. We don't need to do it anymore because we're getting closer to the bottom, so it doesn't take that long. In fact, the next step would be to dig this one down by 7. I think it's 7. Let's just double check here. This one's 7, yeah.
That.
Okay.
I'll do the outside part.
Okay.
So if I was a player, if I was the guy that was hired to do this, mm-hmm. advertise for him, we can see some of these responses, everyone here.
Yeah.
Somebody saw a Twitch stream. So mark this word of mouth, basically.
Okay.
Watched reviewers reviewing, or players, or live streamers playing your game.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I'll keep that in mind. Person getting, you know, wanting to get the game more popular, and I'll think maybe in the future. Okay, I will go and I will look at players that people are watching on Twitch, and I'll try to get them to play our game. Players that match, that I would deem matches our, you know,
ideal player
type of. Ideal gameplay.
Yeah.
Some Minecraft, you know, players. Just something, you know? And if I did that and I was paid to actually get more and more popular, I'd probably try to make it as easy as possible for those players to play. I'd probably make myself available to be on their stream, right? Because doesn't it sound better if, like, I'm streaming this game with the, you know, what would you call it, PR guy for this game, or the community representative for this game, or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and if they have, you know how you watch some of those videos and watch some of those streams, and they get to a point where they're trying to do something in a very short amount of time, right? They're trying to do something in an hour, and of course, they don't have time to learn everything, and all they're thinking is, how do I do this? And everyone that's playing played Wurm for even a few hours would be like, well, you just do this, you just right click here, or you just do that, and they're watching this video frustratingly because they're watching a person that has no idea how to play.
Yeah.
And they're getting frustrated, and you're getting frustrated, and the players that don't know how to play the game are just like, well, this is, you know, not getting a good look. So to solve that, you know, as the PR guy, I would make sure that the people that I'm trying to get to play it, I'd be available for them. So
you'd be on their show or whatever?
I would be on their show.
So you get like MMO Hut, or you get some, like, I don't know, some
whoever,
big company or whatever who's advertising, they're coming to do live streams of Wurm just to check it out and do it for their job or whatever. You're saying that, you know, get a PR guy to be on their show and to walk them through and show them.
Okay, so this could be one strategy.
Okay.
All right, good. Let's see what other people said. Okay, I Googled crafting MMOs back in the day. Good. I literally Googled games like Minecraft. So there's two Google.
Yeah.
I found Wurm through a community tab on the Minecraft website.
I mean, so I wonder what we would get if I typed in sandbox MMO, just in Google. Okay, so let's see what I get.
Actually, number two.
It's actually number two. That's actually pretty good.
That's good. So this is strategy number two. Think of everything that people would possibly type into Google, and then change the website to make Google access it better.
You know, it's actually number one, considering the first one's an ad. So those people pay to be up there. So really,
so maybe done something like that.
Maybe it's. Now go ahead.
You would think of all of the phrases you could possibly think of that would allow players to find your game, that they would type in. Games like Minecraft, a lot of the searches will be like Minecraft. A lot of the searches will have the word sandbox in it. A lot of the searches will have all this stuff in it. You create the website in a way that allows Google to make your website, your game, on the first page at least, if not one of the first three. And there's a technical skill behind that. You can design a website and design it in a way that allows your website to be higher on that Google list. Mm-hmm. I can't remember what it's called. Like SEO or something like that.
And whatever that stands for.
I don't know. Anyway, that hopefully is what they've done. That's definitely what I would do. That's definitely what they should do. But it's more like word of mouth is good, not enough. Are we done?
Nope. We are lagged.
I see. There we go. All right, so here we go. What else have people said?
You know, I feel that a lot of the advertisement has to come from, has to be directed towards those players who are typing these searches. And then when they get there, what they should see is sort of like the reviews on this game, talking about the game in terms of this is a game that it's not for everybody, that it's challenging but rewarding, and give the truth about this game. Because really, what the fear that a lot of people have is that we're going to get an influx of just people who don't like this type of game, who will come in and just badmouth the game because they find it slow or, you know, nothing's going on in it and that sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
So really, these reviews out there have to be truthful about what this game is and what kind of player would enjoy this game. And maybe these reviews need to be written by the staff. Maybe these reviews need to be written by players. I don't know. Whatever it is, I feel like we got to get the word out somehow to target the players who would enjoy this game.
Yeah. So the next one is 11.
Next one's
11. You're right. That is the goal. You are always trying to find players that will enjoy the game that you're making. That's the goal.
Mm-hmm.
So the problem with advertising a game like Wurm is that it's a sandbox, and therefore everyone plays it for different reasons. Mm-hmm. I mean, let's just do everybody up here in the chat window. I see, like, why do you all guys play Wurm? What made you hooked on Wurm? Maybe you guys can talk. I mean, here we have, was it Samantha saying, I thought my boyfriend was a weirdo for playing Wurm, but then he talked me into trying it, and I did. He would love me, and here I am almost 2 years later. What was it that made you play for 2 years?
Mm-hmm.
What was it for all of you guys that made you play it? Are we all playing it for the same reason? Is there something in Wurm that we can say, this is why people will like our game? This is the reason. Let's advertise for this reason, because it'll give, you know, this many players will see our advertisement and they'll be like, oh yeah, that's the game for me. Because, I mean, that's the problem. Let's say you made a video, and that's the problem I had when I made the video. There's your answer. The horses and the farming, because if I don't log in, they will die or so. There you go. You play for the animals and you play for farming. And here, Valor Wurm says designing deeds and how creative I could be doing it. You create. You're playing because of the deed designing aspect. And Samantha's playing because of the animals and the farming. And you've got Definitely the ability to leave a mark on Wurm. So the ability, the fact that the whole world is tangible and you have control, more control over it than other games. You got playing because of the community is so great and all the friends that you've made. Another one for the community.
You know, I play for the leg. Which it seems like we got a whole bunch again. Okay.
What am I doing here?
Am I back? Am I there? Because I think we just had a lag spike.
We might have had a lag spike. I don't know. But I'm just going to keep talking like everyone was just listening to me. I just had to be able to make plate mail, and once I could, I had to be able to make that 99 quality plate mail. Not sure, but working towards that was fun, exciting, and rewarding. I hit a milestone. I'm her boyfriend, by the way, and her in-game name is Dyad.
Oh, perfect.
So there you go. So you're playing because of plate mail. You're playing with someone who plays the game for a completely different reason. So right there. I don't know. Are we back?
I don't even know. I'm loading back into the chat, and I'm going to say, are we back? I feel like...
You can check the OBS and look at the stream kilobits.
Yeah. Things look like they're going.
All right. So as long as the stream kilobits are more than zero, then you're fine.
Yeah.
There you go. I think it was Adam. I think Adam went offline for a second. There.
Yeah.
Anyway, what I was talking about? I was looking up all of you. I was talking about all like what you guys were saying. I feel like the video will still be okay.
I don't know.
The
video will have a little bit of a blip in it, but not big deal. We're back now.
Yeah, so I was saying that, like, even you two guys in the chat there, you know, the boyfriend and girlfriend combo, one of you guys are playing for this reason, plate mail, or this is what got you in, and the other person is playing for this reason, completely different. Mm-hmm. So even though you're playing together, you're playing for different reasons together.
Yeah, absolutely.
How do you market this game to so that you can get the most amount of people to come in based on, let's say you had the attention of 1 minute of somebody's time. That's it, 1 minute. You go over 1 minute, most people won't even get to 1 minute before they judge you.
Yeah.
How in 1 minute you get to hold of somebody's attention when they don't even know what you're about? How do you tell them? Can you tell them, is it good enough to throw as much crap at them as possible in 1 minute? Hey, look, Wurm, you can do this, and you can do this, and you can do this, and you can do that, and you can do that, and you can do this, and you can do this. And then they're like, oh, yeah, I wanted to do the fourth one. That sounded interesting. Would people do that, or would they just be like, wow, that's too much? Or, and I had that problem making the Wurm video that I made a while ago for people that haven't seen it. I'm pretty sure it's still on YouTube. You can look up unofficial Wurm trailer and my video will pop up. But,
and I think that did a good job at giving the gist of the game and making people want to play it. But, you know, I've watched people come in, like I've tried to get people to come play this game, and I've watched them and how they play the initial little bit, and the results are very underwhelming. Like, look at our friend Sasha, who was doing our friend experiment with us.
And, that's right.
You know, on that first episode, this was the first time he ever hopped into the game, like ever. And we tried to make it as authentic as possible. This is what a player would see, and he had us to sort of guide him through it and get the sense of it. But you know, I knew I knew that, like, right from the beginning that he was not going to stick with it. Like, he's definitely not the type of person
I remember trying to figure out why, even while he was doing it. What was he saying? What was he doing that made it so he's already judged it?
Yeah. By the way, I think we messed up. I don't think we need to level this one.
We don't need to level this one.
No, because apparently. Oh shoot, we need to dig this one down to 18. That's why I was wondering, like, why it was going to rock here. If we dig this down to 18, we should be good. I think the next one was 18, right? Let's just go.
I don't remember.
See, this is what happens when you're focusing on a conversation and try to do stuff like this. Oh, no, wait. It goes 14, then 18. It goes 14, then 18. Okay. So,
if we dig this one down, will that be okay?
Let's just double check. What's the slope there now?
41.
No. The one that's maybe next to us. 32 and 30. Let's bring this one up to 14. You know what I mean?
Sorry?
Let's bring this one up so that the slopes are not 30 and 32, but 14 and 12. This is my strategy for saving some time.
Okay, you do it, because I don't understand.
Okay.
I'm going to concentrate on the chat here.
Okay.
Your trailer made me play Wurm. Oh, wow. Thank you. It at least did its job for one player.
Oh, there we go. Yeah. Now, the question is, how long have you been playing, and do you see yourself playing for a long, very long time?
What about the trailer made you play Wurm?
Okay, that's a better question, maybe.
And then the next comment is, isn't the hard learning curve what helps sort out the folks who stick with Wurm and add to the community in the long run? That's another debate altogether. What is the learning curve for Wurm? Why do some players not able to get over the hurdle and other players are? Is it the learning curve in general that makes it so that players quit?
I think.
Here's Zada's here. 80% of people that end up not liking the game is because of the pace and not because of the learning curve, not because of its complexity. Is that true? Or did we just throw a number out of our, lower side?
The pace does play a role, I'm sure. A lot of people don't like the slowness of the game, how long it takes to do anything. Like, you got people coming from Minecraft where you have instant stuff going on there, pretty much. And then they come over here, and it's just like molasses.
Yeah, and we talked about this before. Is the pace the thing? People are, I know players that play Wurm are scared of the game becoming faster, or they relate faster to easier. Mm-hmm. I think we've talked about this before, where we don't relate. I don't think that we really consider the game hard. It just takes time. We're like, well, if we take the time away, does that take away from the game? And right. To the extent, a little bit.
Yeah.
But then we thought, okay, it took us 1 year to create Autumn Twilight. Off and on. Would we consider it less of an achievement if it took 8 months? Would we consider it less of an achievement if it took 7 months or 6 months? It's still 6 months of your time.
Yeah,
That's
and you're
a
talking
long
about
time.
like doubling, you know, like cutting action timers, let's say, for example. If you cut them all in
Yeah.
half, exactly. Yeah.
Who knows? Like, how much shorter can you make it before people are like, well, now it's just so easy.
Right. And like we look at the progress that we're making here, and this has been going on for how long have we been doing this for now? 2 months?
Something like that. No, maybe not that long, but over a month.
Well over a month, I'd say.
Month and a
Anyway,
half.
yeah, a month and a half. And I mean, if let's say we doubled the rate at which we did this, we'd still not be done for sure.
Yeah, and it's like, I think the game still could balance it better. Still could become faster without making it feel easier. Because it's all about the feeling, right? It's not actually easier or harder. We're sitting here clicking the buttons. It's easy. But the feeling of it, the accomplishment that you feel, I still feel that it could be good faster while still earning a sense of accomplishment.
Now, if I can just take
That
a
sort of
if I can just take a break from this conversation for a second to go back to the ramp design or the building of it. So this is what I was trying to say, that this tile here that we were leveling doesn't need to be leveled all the way. I just leveled it so that it was 14. See what I'm saying? And then that way,
Yeah,
when I this tile which was flat that we were standing on, I'm going to dig this down 14. So that I can get it to go from 11 to 14. But then it's by doing that, it's going to be flat with that border over there. So that way, I don't have to level it all the way up to flat and then dig it all back down to 14. And this is a good strategy, especially if you're doing, let's say, a 23 slope. So that way, you don't have to raise it all by 20, like 23 slope, and then dig it all back down by 23. It's a time waster.
okay, so faster timers is a challenge. You tried that and it crashed and burned. Is that really the problem with challenge?
No, that's not the problem with challenge. The problem with challenge was that people knew it was going to reset. That's the problem with challenge.
Yeah,
If.
I think so too, and I don't know. I don't, you'll never know because it was such a short term. What was the problem with challenge? Well, the initial thing is because it was such a short term,
Right.
and no one wanted to really play it
Not many people wanted to
because of.
invest the time, you know, a month to have all that just taken away and now you had nothing.
Essentially testing,
It's
like a
basically going
beta.
into, yeah, it's basically a test server. That's what I felt like it was. They even admitted it was a testing grounds. And the fact that it hasn't come back since elevation even confirms it. This was only temporary.
All right. So anyway,
I think
back to
here,
the
sorry, just before we go on, just so that we know what we're doing next, I think here we can just dig this to 18, and then the rest of the way will be to that flat tile over there.
Okay,
Okay.
so the original topic was just, or we'll go back a bit to Sasha, and what made Sasha not want to play the game? Was it what we were just talking about? Was it the timers? Was it the complexity? What was it?
Like, here's a question. If all of a sudden the game was sped up, would Sasha play it? Would this be a game that Sasha would have liked to play? And I would say it probably would not. It wasn't his type of game. You know, like, he's the type of
What
player.
would have been?
He plays pretty often, I'd say, World of Warcraft still. He went back to that for the new expansion. He wants things to be relatively straightforward, relatively easy, and like in this game, there's like a lot of open-endedness. There's a lot of like I don't even know what I'm gonna do next. You have to create your own goals. You have to sort of look for community and I think that he's the arcadey type player who likes the game to say go here and then go here next and just press buttons in these orders and learn to press them better in a better order so that you're outputting more damage and watching
if you were,
damage
if you were
meters.
A marketing guy.
Sorry?
If you were a marketing guy.
Yeah.
And you looked at a player like this, would you say, I give up on this guy?
Yeah.
He'll never play it.
Absolutely. Absolutely. He will never play this game. And I can guarantee you that.
If you were a designer of the game, could you look at that and I feel like even if you know that that guy would never play it, you could still take pointers from what he disliked about the game.
Right. I think one of the biggest things was the UI for him and the mechanisms in which you do things. But I think that part of the problem is that there's so many different things that you do in this game. Right? Like you can... It was kind of similar to EverQuest where there was so many different buttons that you would hotkey to your bar because there's so many different things that you could do. Whereas you look at a game like World of Warcraft or Guild Wars, they streamlined all of their button
right.
pressing to a specific location, and
right.
it makes it less complicated. And for a person like Sasha, he doesn't want to have to map keys, and he just wants it to be the way it is. And
so maybe we think about that for a bit. What could you guys do? What could we do to market this game? That's the very interesting point as to, what could you do because this game could be so many different facets for so many different people? What do you focus on to get people to play? And you look at, let's say, even the trailers or the videos that's right now for Wurm. You've got the one trailer that's there that you can look at for Wurm.
Yeah.
Right? Well, even other games have more than one trailer. And then you have a game like Wurm, which has so many different ways you can play it. Don't you feel like you would need more than one trailer to showcase all these different ways that you can play it?
Mm-hmm.
So that you can target specific players. If you had 30 seconds or had 1 minute, you can't throw everything at them. You just throw this part of the trailer for this part of it, and then another trailer, and you hope that you cover your bases. Anyway, a little bit to think about. Let's take a look at the archway. Looks like we managed to finish it. Looks pretty good.
Yeah. Now, here's one thing about what I'd like to say about this topic, and I think that the biggest advertising asset that this game has are the players. The players who
yes.
talk about the game in a good light and try to downplay all of the we've seen a lot of negative threads on the town square recently about griefing or about I saw another one recently about I can't find a place to settle, the entire place is totally overpopulated. This sort of thing, and getting the players to downplay that, just advertise on your own, like blogs such as Survivor Man. That was one of the big things that drew me into the game. Like, I feel that recently, there's a lot less of that going on. People blogging about their adventures in Wurm, or just writing about it, or doing screenshots. Storylines of their progress in the game, or people making videos like we do. I mean, one of the main reasons why we started these videos was to advertise this game, and I know it's turned into quite a bit different lately, especially now that we have less time to plan these things and we sort of just are off the cuff for most of it now. But we do these videos because we enjoy it, I would love to see more videos that are designed to advertise this game and put it in a good light. And just, we put a lot of thought into how to explain this game. And I know that, no matter how well you explain this game, it'll always be that niche crafting game that has its, you know, little quirks, but we did our best.
But it doesn't need as you know, less polish because of that.
Yeah. We've seen this game get polished over time, and, you know, sure, it's not a AAA game by any stretch, but it definitely has a charm to it.
That's right. And I think with that, I'm going to have to head out. All right. For a short video. We managed to finish the entire archway.
Let's come down there, because you are the one standing out there thinking that you're showing it to everybody, but really?
Yeah, I'm not.
There it is.
All right. So how does that look? Looks pretty good on your screen.
Looks pretty good.
All right, and even though we know that we have more stuff to fix, but, you know, we'll do that off camera. Now we fix the archway. Yay.
Oh, one last thing. I know you got to run, but one last thing we should show is those mines, those mine entrances that you know, that science experiment we did last week. Oh, you guys are going to laugh. You know how it opened and we're like, yeah, it opened just fine. Perfect. This is that exact mine entrance. We log in just now and this is what happened.
This is what I was talking about.
What is this?
It's not a mine. It's like it opened in two separate directions at the same time.
Like, it was fine the last time we had it on video. It was fine, right?
Yes, we have it on video of it opening up properly, and then we relogged, came back in, and it was like this.
I think I looked at it again and it was fine. It must have been our server restart or something.
Yeah.
Or something messed it all up and it became a corner mine and we cannot use it. So what is going on here? You know, after that video, I went and created a corner mine like this. I made a mine that, because we wanted to have a building right here.
Really fascinated about how it could be flat. Mine entrance could be flat.
I wanted all this. I'm like, yeah. So all this, I wanted all this flat, and then I wanted this mine entrance to open this way. And I did it, and I'm like, oh, perfect. It opened perfectly fine. It went down, and it had a wall here, and everything like that. And then I guess that server reset or something happened, and it now is a corner mine. And now we can't do that.
Yeah, what does that mean? I don't know. We'll have to redesign some stuff. We'll have to collapse some things. But there it is. We actually showed the bug. A mine that is completely bugged out. Oh, there's a spider. Okay.
Yeah.
So what can you say? We fixed one of our problems. We got a few more things to fix. And we showed that mines in Wurm can be bugged out.
Yep.
Whether that's good or bad, I don't know. Anyway, I have to run. Thank you everyone for watching today. Now it's a quick video, but we'll be back next week with more chatting. We have so much more to talk about. Mm-hmm. We just can't do it this week. Anyway, Adam, thanks for letting me join you for an hour or so.
Yep, no problem.
And we'll play again in a little bit. Thanks everyone for joining us on Twitch and everyone watching on YouTube. And we'll see you guys next week.